to an incredible journey over the last 2 years. My next shot. Sorry, it's. So you can see our results. The group has changed a lot, shifting from a 15,000 people group to more than a 20,000 people group. The revenue went up significantly, 5% last year organically and 5% the year before. And if you take into consideration the Forex effects and the acquisitions, it's even almost 20% growth last year. If you go to the next chart, you will see that the years have been incredible in terms of new business activities. For Havas Creative Group, you can see all the great win. We have just highlighted some of them. If you move to the next chart, you will see that for Havas Media Group, we have been through a fantastic journey. You can see every quarter, basically, we are onboarding a new global clients. And Havas Media, I would say, has almost doubled its size. And just to give you a figure about the importance of global clients in Havas Media, we only had one global client, I would say, 5 years from now. And now the sum of the global clients represent more than the half of the global organization, which shows that we have managed at Havas Media Group to adapt to this new reality, which is to be more and more a global network, and that the shift from a multi-local to a global network has been a success. If you go to the next chart, you will see some wins highlighted from everywhere in the world, from Germany with Dr. Wolf, the prestigious BBC account, and some win very important in the rest of the world. Maybe to announce that we have just found out yesterday that we won the biggest pitch for us we were in, which was a track phone, a prepaid phone brand in the United States, which will be become the top three client in the US. So we are very happy. Laurie is here, so she's the one who is Colin. I don't know if Colin is here. So they have done a great job. Last year also have been a big change in terms of acquisition. You know that Havas, we were not, and even last year we said we are not the group doing the more acquisition. But last year we have been proven wrong because we did 13 of them, being one of the leaders in the M&A activity. If you go to the next chart, you will see that the acquisitions have been done all over the world. In the United States with the Plastic Mobile doing extremely well, two acquisitions in the healthcare, a very important acquisition in Central America, Tribu, with my friend Jorge Buravina. We had a fantastic time in Costa Rica 2 weeks ago, when a little bit tan, no, not say no. And this is the leader in the region doing extremely well. If you go southeast, we are very proud with the acquisition of River Orchid. It's not closed yet, so I think the closing will appear, I hope, in the weeks to come. And one in Vietnam, and six different acquisitions in Europe, including a market research acquisition, CSA, very famous in France, which we think we will roll out in the rest of the world. And of course, the largest acquisition we have made over the last decade, Full Six Group, which is basically the leader in the digital space in Europe with a presence in the United States. If you go to the next chart, you will see the map of the villages. You know, Havas strategy has been for the last 3 years to be the first group to create an integrated offer, allowing our people to work where possible under one roof. So we came up with the idea of the villages. We did villages one by one. I'm very proud to say that we are about to finish our work, at least our building work in terms of village. The red points shows the villages already existing, and the green points show the villages that has opened this year. If you go to the next chart, you will see that 2016, you will see some picture of Havas Village Mexico, obviously. Maybe you can go fast just to see some picture, to see how it looks like. So this is India, Fornur, Jakarta, Dublin, and number one in Manchester, Bangkok. For 2016, we will open our villages in Europe. It will be the last one. I know we have some pictures just after. This is Barcelona, where we are market leader. Madrid as well will open this year. This is going to be a big one. You know, London is supposed to be our European headquarter. We will see what happens tomorrow. So we need a pretty important, a pretty significant investment. So please, for British citizens, vote yes, but stay. It's important for us. Okay, but this will look cool. And this will be the new one in Paris for BTC Group in a very popular neighborhood. It's going to be great, completely disrupting the way we used to work. So this is how it really looks like. And the next picture show how we would like it to look like. So it's not the truth was the previous one. And so if we go to the next chart, you will see that for 2016, we don't want to change anything. It has worked fantastically well for 2014 and 2015. So 2016 will be for us the year of the acceleration of our strategy. We think we have been basically the first one to promote this integrated approach. But we believe that now, if we say the truth, all the group that you can say on the Croisette, they all say the same thing, that they come together. Everybody has a different name. But at the end of the day, it's more or less the same strategy in order to meet clients' expectations. So we used to say that we are 2 years ahead of the competition and we want to remain those 2 years ahead. If you look at the next chart, you will see that the beginning of the year has been great. The Q1 has been up 7%, organically plus 3.6%, which makes us one of the fastest growing group of the industry. Maybe to highlight four wins that are for us very important because it demonstrates clearly our ability to win together, not agency by agency working in silo, but really together. Telecom Italia between Italy and Brazil, for Team Brazil. Teva, which has been, you have seen maybe, has won two Lions last weekend, and two wins thanks to Full Six. So you know Full Six, I mentioned it earlier, has been the biggest acquisition. It's part of more what we say Havas Creative Group. You know, we still operate in two divisions, Havas Creative Group and Havas Media Group. And Havas Creative Group with Full Six has done a tremendous job. The integration is already a success. And today, I'm very proud to announce you, together with Marco, maybe if you want to join me. Marco Tinelli is, you can applaud Marco, he's the founder of Full Six. I look more digital than you. Yeah, just coming here. So, if you go to the next chart, we are very proud to announce the launch of Full Six Media, which will be our third media network alongside Havas Media and Arena Media, which is for us a very big news. Maybe you want to.
Yeah, I just arrived from Paris, this is why I've got my jacket on. And
we will offer you all the t-shirts now.
Thank you so much. So Full Six Media is going to be, we hope, a big launch. And the third network of the LS Group in terms of media, very focused on programmatic, digital and data. Full Six has always been a story about trying to do things in a slightly different way in the industry, which is not putting online and digital on the side, but putting it at the core of what we do. And we're hoping to craft, with our colleagues, a new way of doing media which starts online and then embraces all channels to deliver more performance. So we've built the tools, we have the data, we have the energy, and we hope it's going to be a great adventure.
Thank you. Thank you, Marco. The launch of Full Six Media will be 1st of September, so you will hear more about that, but it's I'm sure it's going to be a great success trying to get the first network being fully programmable. If you go to the next chart, we sum up together the two or three announcements Havas Creative Group has made over the last 10 days. Two very important announcements in terms of digital transformation. You know, digital is at the heart of what we do since 10 years. We don't even mention digital anymore, it's in our blood. We have announced a very important partnership with IBM, Watson, about cognitive intelligence. So we are one of their key partners to develop this ability to create predictive marketing and all to develop this fantastic algorithm with our clients. It's a big thing, so cognitive intelligence is progressing a lot at Havas. And maybe you've seen yesterday, we have announced the hiring of a very senior talent from the consulting space, coming from McKinsey, to lead digital transformation within our clients. This one is very important because it's really the first step of what we want to do in the consulting space. We hear a lot everywhere that advertising agencies are getting disrupted by tech platforms and consulting firms. My take is clearly that for us, it's a great opportunity to go in the field of consulting. We are very smart people at Havas, very smart planners, and I'm sure that together we can create an offering, very interesting offers in the consulting space. So 1st of January next year, our goal is to announce the launch of a very important consulting-based offering called Havas Consulting Group. 1st of January next year, we're working on that and we are ready to invest a lot. We are sure of our future success. And something about brand innovation, if you just go back to the previous slide, you know we have announced a partnership with Troy Carter from Atom Factory about brand innovation. He's the first one to launch, how do you say, James? James is the CEO, so maybe you want to say a word about what is Smash and what this offering is?
Smash Group is a brand innovation. Oh, thank you, Mike, James. Hey, guys. Smash Group is a brand innovation consultancy. Troy Carter has been very successful in the tech investment space. He's been very successful as a music manager. And so we're combining both the expertise of the entertainment business and Silicon Valley and bringing them together for an offering called Smash Group. And we're excited to be here. Thanks.
Thank you very much, James. And last but not least, we're very proud to announce our third announcement of the day, and last, about digital transformation. It's Havas IT 35. I wanted to create some surprise effect, but it's here. So I had an intro, which was Havas has been created in 1835 by a great disruptor of his time, Charles Havas. He's not my family, Charles Havas, but great guy. Who was the first one to invent advertising, and in his time, he has completely disrupted the world as it was. So we try to get inspired by this disruptive mindset, by this entrepreneurship mindset, and we have decided to gather every piece of innovation and technology and entrepreneurship across the group to create this new offering, which will be part of the Havas Group. Basically, the idea is to found some initiatives about innovation, to ask more people, to ask people from the outside, maybe you have an idea, how can we help you to be the entrepreneur and to make it a reality? I think it's very important when we are part of a large group like Havas with 20,000 people, even larger if you take all the Bolloré group into consideration, more than 100,000 people. I think it's very important that we keep this mindset of entrepreneurship. It's one of our key values, and we believe we need to show to our people that together with Havas, we can help them achieve crazy ideas, and we will support them. So without making you wait any longer, we have the first things coming out of this Havas 1835 approach. Maybe I will pass the floor to Raphaël Diandrouis, the CEO of Havas Media Group in France, who came up with an original idea.
Borrow your microphone. I think this one. I don't know whether it works. Okay. Thanks, Yannick. Yes, I think like we won't wait any longer. I invite you.
In this one work. Okay, sorry. You won't wait any longer. We're gonna invite you in the garden, a few steps from here, to discover a product. So please follow me. That has been designed and engineered by our teams.